Hello friends, this is Bindu Kumar here. Let's look at this question. In which of the following situations does the list of numbers involved make an arithmetic progression and why? So we should look at the different situations and identify the list of numbers and then check if those list of numbers make an arithmetic progression. The situation given here is the amount of air present in a cylinder when a vacuum pump removes 1/4 of the air remaining in the cylinder at a time. So what it says is there is a cylinder and there is a vacuum pump that removes 1/4 of the air remaining in the cylinder. Okay, so every time the vacuum pump runs, it removes 1/4 of the remaining air in the cylinder. So with this, let's try and write down what we can understand. So we know there is a cylinder, but we do not know what is the amount of air in it. So we will assume it is X. So there is X amount of air in the cylinder initially. Now, when the vacuum pump runs for the first time, it is said it will remove 1/4 of the air remaining. Now, once the vacuum pump runs for the first time, there would be X minus 1/4 of X air remaining in the cylinder. Right? So let's solve this equation. So this will be X minus 1/4 X. I'll take X as the common factor or the common number. That leaves us with 1 minus 1/4 in the bracket. So if you multiply this, you will get back this statement. Now 1 minus 1/4, how do we solve this? I'll say X. So in case you do not know how to subtract a whole number with a fraction, it's pretty easy. First, let's convert the whole number into a fraction as well. 1 divided by 1 minus 1/4. Now, the next step will be X. The numerator of the first number into the denominator of the second number. So which is 4 into 1. Then what is the sign here? It is minus. And then the numerator of the second number into the denominator of the first number, which is 1 into 1 divided by the denominator into denominator, 4 into 1. So that will give us X into 4 minus 1 divided by 4, which is equal to 3 by 4. 3 by 4 X. So 3 by 4 X is the air remaining after the pump runs, or after the vacuum pump runs for the very first time. Now, what happens when it runs for the second time? Again, it's given in the question, it will remove 1/4 of the air remaining. So what is the air remaining here? It is 3/4 of X, right? So let's write it down here. There is 3 by 4 X air remaining. Now when I run the pump, it is going to remove 1/4 of air remaining, which is again 3 by 4 of X. Now let's simplify this. So here you will see 3 by 4 X, and 3 by 4 X is common. So I'll take that as the common number outside the bracket, and inside the bracket I'll have 1 minus 1/4. Okay, now let's solve what is there in the bracket. Now here you'll see something common, which is 1 minus 1/4 is the same as here. And what did we get for 1 minus 1/4? We got the value of 3/4 finally, correct? So we will use that same calculation and we will write it as 3 by 4 X, which is the same as this, into Now instead of 1 minus 1 by 4, we know that it is, can be simplified to 3 by 4. Okay, so we now have 3 by 4x into 3 by 4, which can be written as 3 by 4 square x. Okay, so now this is the amount of air remaining once the pump runs for the second time. Okay, now similarly, let's do it for the third time as well. So third time, when the pump runs, it will again remove 1/4 of the air remaining. So what is the air remaining now? It is 3 by 4 square x. Now the pump runs and it will remove 1/4 of 3 by 4 square x. We will simplify this. Here we have 3 by 4 square x and 3 by 4 square x as the common number. So I'll write 3 by 4 square x into 1 minus 1 by 4, which equals 3 by 4 square x into, now again, here you will see we have 1 minus 1 by 4, which will give me the same result, which is 3 by 4. So using that, I'll write 3 by 4 again. So now we have 3 by 4 square into 3 by 4x. So which will become 3 by 4 to the power of 3, or cube we can say. Right? So this is the amount of air remaining in the pump or in the cylinder after the pump runs for the third time. So this is the list of numbers. Now we can continue writing as many numbers as we want in the list, right? But what are we, what should we do here? We should find out if the list of numbers make an arithmetic progression. So we already have four numbers, right? So where are those four numbers? We have A1 here, right? We have A2 here, A3 and A4 here. So let me write that list here. We have x, we have 3 by 4x. Let me put 3 by 4 in a bracket. Then we have 3 by 4 square x, and we have 3 by 4 cube x. Now this is of the form A1, A2, A3, A4. Correct? Now what do we know about an arithmetic progression? In an arithmetic progression, if we have numbers, let's say A1, A2, A3 and A4, they are said to be in arithmetic progression if they are of the form A plus D, A plus 2D and so on, where D is the common difference. It can be calculated by subtracting A of n from A of n plus 1. For example, D can be calculated by A3 minus A2, and it should also be equal to A2 minus A1. Now let's apply this formula to this list of numbers to see if it becomes an arithmetic progression. So first, let me just write a line here. We'll calculate D equal to A3 minus A2. Now A3 is 3 by 4 square x. So I'll write 3 by 4 square x minus A2. A2 is 3 by 4 x. And here you'll see 3 by 4 x is common. So I'll take that out. And within the bracket, I'll have 3 by 4 minus 1. So solving this, I'm going to get 3 by 4 x into, again, the same principle here. I'll convert the whole number to a fraction. numerator into denominator, again numerator into denominator, and then denominator into denominator, which will be 3 into 1 minus 4 into 1 divided by 4, which will give me 3 by 4x into 3 minus 4 by 4, which is 3 by 4x into minus 1 by 4. So this is the common difference that we have identified between A3 minus A2. Now let's see if the same value we will get for A2 minus A1 also. So I am running out of space, so I'm going to delete this calculation here. Okay, so but I'll keep the result as is. Now let's find out D equal to A2 minus A1 and see if we get the same result. So what is A2? A2 is 3 by 4x minus x. Now here you can see x is common, so I'll keep x outside the bracket and I'll say 3 by 4 minus 1, which will give me x into. So here again, I'll do numerator into denominator, denominator into numerator, and denominator into denominator. So which will get me 3 into 1 minus 4 into 1 divided by 4. Which is x into 3 minus 4 by 4, which is equal to minus 1 by 4x. So this is the common difference that we are getting. Now, as you can see, this and this are not equal, right? So for A3 minus A2, this is the answer that we got, which is 3 by 4x into minus 1 by 4. For A2 minus A1, this is the answer that we are getting. So clearly with this, we can see that this list of numbers is not an arithmetic progression because they do not have the same common difference between the different terms. Hence, we can say that this is not an arithmetic progression. Remember to like, subscribe, and click on the bell button to get notified of new videos.